Hello and welcome. Today, I wanted to share with you what, in my opinion, is the single most useful decorator in Python. Taking a look at the code that's already written here, first we have a function which computes the nth Fibonacci number, and it does so in a recursive fashion, so it's extremely inefficient. Next, in our main function, we have just a loop going through 400 numbers, just printing out the number and the ith Fibonacci number. And then at the end, we print done. Now, if I were to actually run this code, you would see that while the first few go very quickly, it starts grinding to a halt around 31, 32, 33. And essentially, each number after that takes twice as long as the number before it. And this is because of the bad implementation of the Fibonacci function that we've given here. The main problem with this implementation is that when I compute fib of n minus 1, well, part of that computation is to compute fib of n minus 2. So I'm doing a lot of repeated work here. Every level down, I'm going to be repeating work that has already been done and then just was thrown away in a different function call. An easy way to fix this is just by remembering values that have already been computed. And that's what the decorator does. So my favorite decorator in Python is the cache decorator from the functools library. So functools is a built-in, so you don't have to install anything. And then you just hit your Fibonacci function with cache. And now let's go ahead and try running it again. You see it goes through all 400 of them immediately. And the reason for that was that even though we have this very inefficient definition, what cache does is it just remembers all of the values of the function that it's computed before. So if you compute fib of 398, then when I compute fib of 399, it looks up fib of 398 and 397, and it says, oh, I've already computed both of those things. Instead of recomputing them using this recursive definition, it will just use the value that it's remembered from the previous time that you've run the function. So I find this to be extremely useful because it allows you to avoid repeated computations. There's also a variant of cache called LRU cache. LRU stands for least recently used, and it does essentially the same thing, but instead of storing all previous values of the function that you've called it with, it only stores a certain number of them. So let's just replace this with an LRU cache and give it a max size of, say, 5. This means that it's just going to store the 5 most recent values of the function that I've called. Now, if I'm just running up values of the function in a for loop like this, then that's plenty just to do this. So still, if I run the function, it completes just as fast as before. And this way, I'm only using a little bit more memory, but it's a huge speed up compared to when there was no cache at all. So I find myself using cache or LRU cache in a lot of different projects, just anywhere where I can see myself accidentally repeating computations that might take a long time. That's a great place to just throw it in, a cache or an LRU cache. You don't have to do any other work, and it can provide a lot of speed up if you know the right place to use it.